I'ma look at you. There's so many things that I wanna do. I promise you when I'm ready that I'll spend my life with you. What is love? Is it steady? 'Cause I don't know what to do. So tell me, girl, are you ready to do what we came to do?
Yeah. All right now. What's going on, y'all? Welcome to another episode of the Mack Lessons Radio Show. And my name is Mr. Tariq Elite. And I'm glad to have everybody tuning into the show. Beautiful, beautiful day today. I'm going to chop up some good game. Today is actually my 200th show. This is the 200th show of the Mack Lessons Radio Show, the 200th episode. So we're at a milestone. I was going to do something spectacular, something special. I'm just going to spit game. I'm going to spit some deep game, but I'm just going to spit some good old-fashioned game on my 200th episode of the Mack Lessons Radio Show. And I'm glad everybody has been supporting the show for this long, chopping up game with me, learning game, respecting the game, being a part of the game, trying to maintain the game. I respect that, man. Much love to all the listeners out there. Now, I have a very special pay-per-view special that's available right now. I have a pay-per-view special, and I'm surprised I haven't done this special already, because a lot of people always send me emails asking me about this particular subject. But the pay-per-view special, if you go to MackLessons.com, go to the pay-per-view section, the new pay-per-view special is Dating Women with Kids. I get a million emails about this, and I've been getting emails for years about how do you date women with kids? Is it cool to date women with kids? What's your opinion on dating women with kids? And now you can listen to the special and chop up the game and soak up the game. I go real deep into it. Very, very good pay-per-view special. For any cat out there who's considering dating a female who has kids, do not date a woman who has kids until you listen to that show. And ladies, you can listen to it too, because there's some good game in there for you. You might learn something about yourself. But fellas, do not date no female with kids until you listen to that show. I give the pros and the cons. It's a very good show. MackLessons.com, Dating Women with Kids. Now, today's show, I want to talk about the psychology and the mentality of a hustler. I did a show a while back about rules on being a hustler, and I was giving guys ideas on what types of hustles to get into. But right now, I want to just talk about the mentality that a hustler should have, a real hustler. And I've talked about this particular movie before, my favorite movie, Carlito's Way. And I'm going to use that as an example throughout the show today on how to have a mentality of a hustler. And as a matter of fact, I want you guys to watch the Carlito's Way movie before you listen to this show. You can pause this show and go YouTube or find the Carlito's Way movie somewhere online and look at it before you listen to the show so you can feel what I'm saying. If you haven't seen that movie, everybody should have seen this movie already. Carlito's Way is a great, great movie. And I've said this before, that Carlito's Way is a great movie on how to be a hustler. Excellent movie on how to be a hustler. But before we get into that, I want to talk about some things that's going on in the media right now. As a lot of people know, Bill Clinton went over to North Korea and he helped free two political prisoners. There were these two female journalists. One was the sister of journalist Lisa Ling. They were over in North Korea. they made a mistake and crossed over to the North Korean border, and they were taken prisoner, and they were sentenced to like 12 years in prison, hard labor. And a lot of our public officials were trying to negotiate their release, but Bill Clinton went over there on some player shit and scooped them right on up, and they got back early yesterday morning. Now, I have exclusive footage of the meeting between Bill Clinton and North Korean leader Kim Jong-il. Now, this is exclusive footage of them negotiating the release of the females. Bill Clinton and Kim Jong-il, this is the official undercover footage.
I mean, you know the rules of the game. I mean, your bitch just chose me. Now, we can settle this like you got some class, so we can get into some gangster shit.
You shade tree nigga. You ain't no pimp. You're a rest haven for hoes. You're a car thief. A car thief. The one you got out there is probably hot as a firecracker right now.
Oh, it was $35,000.
Huh? $35,000 cash money?
No, I get $35,000 plus one, right?
The one I gave.
No, you gave me six, though, right?
That's
it was
true.
One. I had one. It was six. And $35,000 plus one plus six leaves seven. $35,000 and seven, right? Motherfucker, can you buy that?
And there you go. I digress. Anyway, y'all, let me put on some Mackin' music. Let me get my Mackin' groove on. Another thing is, I've been getting a lot of footage. People have been sending me links of Stephon Marbury's ass acting a goddamn fool on the internet. This nigga is he's lost his goddamn mind. Stephon Marbury, this nigga is doing videos naked, doing the Laffy Taffy. This nigga has lost his mind. Eating Noxzema and Vaseline. This nigga has given him some good crack. I mean, some good crack. I don't know why none of his friends or family members will not step to this dude and pull him to the side and get this nigga some help or something. For those who don't know, Stephon Marbury is a basketball player. I don't know if he's still playing or if he's a former basketball player, but he has lost his damn mind. This dude has clearly had a nervous breakdown, and somebody needs to have some kind of intervention for this guy. I really feel for the guy. This guy is just losing his mind in front of everybody, in front of the world. So they need to do something about Stephon Marbury, but I digress. Anyway, man, let's get into some game. That's what y'all want to do, right? Y'all want to get into some game? God damn it, we're going to get into some game right now. So like I said, man, I want to get you into the mentality of a hustler. I want to show you how a hustler thinks. And we're going to use the movie Carlito's Way as an example. Now, I know a lot of you guys, when it comes to Al Pacino movies, a lot of you guys like Scarface. A lot of brothers like Scarface because Scarface is the kind of guy who shoot first, ask questions later. That rah-rah gangster, fuck the world, me against the world shit. That's how niggas like thinking. That's going to get you fucked up in the game. Which is, Scarface is a great movie. I like Scarface, but Carlito's Way, much better movie. I liked it better because the character Carlito was a real hustler. He was a thinker. Everything was calculated. And I want to give some examples. I'm going to give you five tips on how to have the mentality of a hustler. And you can apply this to anything you do, your daily life. Especially my guys out there in the street game. If you're in the street game, you really need to pay attention to what I'm about to spit. Now, number one, the number one tip, the number one rule, the number one mentality you should have. When you are a hustler, you should always take advantage of lucky breaks. Because every now and then, luck comes our way, which is rare. You don't depend on luck, but you take advantage of lucky breaks. In the movie Carlito's Way, when Carlito, the movie opens up, Carlito's in court. He gets released on a technicality. I think he was going to do a long stretch in prison, but there was some kind of technical thing, some kind of mix-up, and he was released out of jail early. And once he got released from jail, he was going to go on the straight and narrow. He wasn't going to be on no bullshit. His main goal was to try to walk the straight and narrow, which is smart. That's what a hustler is supposed to do if you get a second chance, if you get a lucky break. A lot of cats don't think like hustlers. Let me give an example, like O.J. Simpson. O.J. Simpson was acquitted in the trial of the century for murdering a white woman. If you are a black man, a famous black man like O.J. Simpson, and you get acquitted for a major crime like that, that the world is watching, you take your ass on somewhere. And I don't mean to Florida. You take your ass to Africa or Russia. You get the hell out of the country. That's what you do. You don't sit up in Florida playing golf and flossing. That's not what you do. You gotta bounce. You gotta know when to bounce. And another cat, Larry Davis out of New York. All you New York cats know who he is. Larry Davis, he was acquitted of shooting a cop. I think that was the case. But he was acquitted and he didn't bounce. He stayed in New York. If you get acquitted of killing a cop or shooting a cop, you bounce. You take advantage of your good fortune and you get the hell out of Dodge. You got to do an Osama bin Laden. Bin Laden is lucky and he's taking advantage of his luck. That's why he's still alive to this day. And Michael Jackson, when Michael was alive, when Michael was acquitted of the child molestation charges, Mike got out of the country. Mike took his ass over to Bahrain. And there was a reason why he went to Bahrain. I mean, I know he had friends over there and all that stuff, but a lot of folks don't know. And Bahrain, that's one of the few non-extradition countries. You can't extradite somebody from Bahrain just in case they wanted to convict him of another crime or accuse him of another crime. You can't go and extradite anyone from Bahrain. You can do it from other countries, but Bahrain is one of the countries you can't extradite a person from, no matter what. So you always take advantage of your lucky breaks. There's cats out here, man. You see cats who get lucky breaks and then they'll keep fucking up. That's not hustler. People give you break after break after break and your luck runs out. That just like the movie Scarface. Scarface, Tony Montana was just a lucky dude. This dude was just so gangster and bold. He lucked up on a lot of money and his luck ran out and he got killed. So you never depend on luck, but when luck comes your way, you just take advantage of that. That's a very important rule. Like T.I., I'm going to give the rapper T.I., I give him props. T.I. was very smart. T.I. lucked the hell up. With all that stuff they caught him with, that dude could have got life in prison. But when he got that year in prison, he straightened his whole game up. He put on his Easter suit and he was playing Mr. Goody Two Shoes all in the media. Doing the redemption show, helping out teenagers. I mean, he was really, really being on the straight and narrow, and that's how you do. So I commend him for that. If you get a lucky break, man, there's a time to floss and there's a time to chill. Sometimes you can't floss all the time. You gotta lay real low sometimes. Sometimes you gotta fall back. Sometimes you gotta walk away from shit. Flossing gets cats caught up big time. You gotta know when to lay low. Sometimes you can't be shopping in Beverly Hills. Sometimes you gotta hit up Ross for less. And while you bullshitting, I start fucking with Ross for a minute. I was in Hawaii, and it gets hot as hell out there in Hawaii, and I need to buy some sneakers and some stuff, and they don't hardly have my shit out here, my size, because I'm 6'5", and I wear like a size 15 shoe, so you know, I can't go to no regular store and get my shoe size, I gotta go to Ross. So I went to Ross, and Ross had some pretty nice shit on the cheap, while you bullshitting. Some of it is bootleg. I'm not fronting. Some of the shit at Ross is bootleg now. because I saw some Jordans in there, some bootleg-ass Jordans. And you know how on Air Jordans, the real ones, they have a silhouette of Michael Jordan dunking? Them shits I got at Ross, they had a silhouette of Juanita Jordan with a wig on and an alimony check. Them shits was busted. But they do have some nice shit in there, though. But I digress. But anyway, like I said, you got to know when to take advantage of your lucky breaks. Now, number two. The number two rule of being a hustler, the number two mentality to have, a real hustler does not get blinded by friendship. In the movie Carlito's Way, Carlito, when he got out of jail, he met up with his cousin. His cousin was half a square, half a hustler trying to get in the game, young, dumb dude, and he wanted to have Carlito go on a drug run with him. So Carlito went with him just to kind of watch his back because he knew his cousin was kind of square. So they go to this pool hall and there's a bunch of shiesty characters there, and Carlito immediately knew something was up and he tried to save his cousin, but his cousin ended up getting killed. So as a hustler, you're always peeping everybody out. You ain't on that friend shit, because Carlito's cousin was like, oh yeah, these are my friends. Oh, they're cool people. Carlito knew better. As a hustler, nobody's really your friend, especially cats you really don't know like that, cats you didn't grow up with. These are not your buddies. And that's the mistake a lot of people make. You start thinking that people that you just met are genuinely your friends. And it's not good to be overly cynical, but you have to be cautious if you're going to be a hustler. And that's with anything you do, especially out here in Hollywood. In Hollywood, people are very good on that I'm your best friend shit. You meet somebody and they act like they're your best buddy. These motherfuckers are not your friend. They'll stab you in the back very quickly. People are very selfish to a certain degree. It's all about, you know, what can you do for them? That's the mentality in the game, and that's the mentality in Hollywood. That's why a lot of people end up on drugs, because all these people are bullshitting you, telling you how fly you are and how much they're your friend, and then you realize they don't give a shit about you. So you want to go hit that pipe to feel better about yourself. But always keep people at arm's length to a certain degree. Now, let's go to rule number three. Number three, always plan to parlay yourself out the game. And that's what Carlito was doing. When Carlito went to the pool hall, these cats killed his cousin. Carlito ended up killing them. And he took some drugs and some money that was left over. So Carlito said, okay, let me figure out how to flip this and get out the game. So what he did, his main goal was to invest in this club, make $75,000, and move out of the country. That was his whole goal. A lot of cats out here who are hustling don't know how to parlay themselves out the game, because the game is very addictive. You get in the game and you don't really hone in on any other skills. You get very comfortable in your hustle, and you don't know how to parlay yourself out the game. You got to parlay yourself out the game. And again, being a hustler is very addictive, because a lot of cats will say, well, let me make this last $20,000 and I'm out. Then you make that $20,000. Then you say to yourself, well, damn, if I can make $20,000, let me make this last $40,000. Then I'm out. Then you make that $40,000. Then you're like, fuck it. If I can make $40,000 this easily, let me just go ahead and get $60,000 and I'm done. And it just never stops. It just keeps going and going and going. Because once you figured out a hustle that works for you, you don't want to give that up. You become addicted to it. You don't want to give that money up. That gets a lot of cats caught up. Like Frank Lucas. Y'all remember him, the guy from American Gangster? This guy had $250 million. He should have stopped. But his mentality is, if I can make $200 million, let me make $400 million. So you got to know how to parlay yourself out the game. Now, number four. Now, this is a very pivotal one from the movie Carlito's Way. Carlito's Way, Carlito ran into this character named Benny Blanco from the Bronx, played by John Leguizamo. How am I pronouncing his name? Leguizamo? I don't know. Leguizamo? Something like that. And I was on Conan O'Brien with the guy. I can't even pronounce his name. I did a talk show with him before. I was on the same talk show with him. Leguizamo. Is that his name? I think that's his name. It's late. Anyway, but the character was Benny Blanco from the Bronx. Now, the character was a guy. He was a hustler, up-and-coming hustler. And he was trying to get buddy-buddy with Carlito to kind of soak up some game from him. A lot of the young cats like to get around the old-school cats and just kind of steal game from them. They'll play that buddy-buddy, hey, you my friend, all that shit. And Carlito peeped that shit from a mile away. He's like, eh, whatever, kid. Get out of here. Beat it. Just kind of played them to the left a little bit. And Benny Blanco's character, the character Benny Blanco, was getting offended because Carlito kept playing him to the left. And, you know, Benny Blanco wanted to be the Big Willie dude. So he started stepping to Carlito on some disrespect shit. In his spot, he came up to Carlito's club and he was kind of disrespecting him. Then he started blatantly disrespecting him. So Carlito had a choice. Carlito could have had the guy killed, or he could have let him go. And there were devastating consequences to both sides of those decisions. If Carlito would have killed Benny Blanco, the feds and the cops would have been back on Carlito, because the law enforcement and the district attorney, they were trying to get at Carlito anyway, because they were already mad because he beat the case. So they were watching him anyway. So he had to be on his P's and Q's. Also, if you're in the game, you're out here in the streets, and you let a cat disrespect you, that's real dangerous. That's a very dangerous thing, because once people in the game know that they can disrespect you, it's a wrap. Everybody's going to try to play you soft. And just like Carlito said in the movie, the streets are always watching. So a lot of people think that he should have killed Benny Blanco from the Bronx. No, Carlito did not kill Benny Blanco from the Bronx. He beat him up a little bit, told him to beat it. Don't ever come around here again. Benny Blanco was like, yeah, you should have killed me. If I see you again, I'm going to kill you, blah, blah, blah. So a lot of folks said the mistake that Carlito made, he should have killed Benny Blanco. He should not have killed Benny Blanco. He did the right thing. He thought like a hustler. He used diplomacy. That's the fourth rule. Always be diplomatic with your decisions. He weighed his options. And he chose the better option. Because if he let Benny Blanco go, the street dudes, they'll try to get at him. But by that time, he would be gone. Because Carlito, his main goal was to get out of the country, parlay himself out the game. If he would have killed him, law enforcement would have been on him. And he couldn't have gotten away from that. No matter where he went, law enforcement would have been trying to get at him. Anywhere he went. So he made the right decision at that point. Now that brings us to number five. Now in the movie, the climax of the movie, Carlito, he got his lady, and his best friend was helping him get away. He was going to meet his best friend and his lady at the bus station, at the train station, and he was going to get on the train to Miami and take a plane or something like that with his lady. By the time Carlito got to the train station, found out that his homeboy, his best friend that he grew up with, set him up. Benny Blanco was waiting there for him, and Benny Blanco shot him and killed him. Now, a lot of people say that that's the mistake he made. He let Benny Blanco live. But again, that wasn't the mistake. That brings us to rule number five. Never put 100% trust in anybody but yourself. He made the mistake of trusting his friend too much. The thing is, in the movie, there was a part in the movie where somebody told Carlito, hey man, your homeboy, your best friend, the word on the street is that he's kind of rolling with Benny Blanco. Somebody warned Carlito, but Carlito didn't take heed to it. They actually warned him. That's the mistake he made. Because he had the paranoia of a hustler, because a lot of hustlers are very paranoid. And you have to be if you're going to be in the game. But he trusted his homeboy that he grew up with, and he didn't think that his homeboy would cross him like that. And he did. That's the thing. You can't trust nobody 100% if you're a hustler. Real hustlers know what I'm talking about. A real hustler don't even trust their mama 100%. You know that everybody's capable of flipping on you. So that's the only mistake that Carlito made in the movie. He played everything strategically. That's the mistake he made. So that's the mistake that you should not make. Never trust anybody 100%. I know that sounds cynical, but you only trust yourself. At the end of the day, you came in the world by yourself. You're going to go out by yourself. You trust you. If you got a wife or a girlfriend, you can trust her 98%. But you never know. And you have to be cynical like that, especially if you're going to be on some hustle shit. And again, you can parlay that into many other things. So that's just a basic example of the mentality of a hustler. And you guys really need to see that movie and just soak it in, because that's a very good movie. Anyway, y'all, that's been today's episode of the Mack Lessons Radio Show. I'm glad everybody tuned in. Don't forget to check out the pay-per-view special, Dating Women with Kids. Go to MackLessons.com and check that out. I will holler at you guys next week. Peace.